Morning, boys.
Morning, Matt.
How's it hanging?
Hi, George.
Hey, guys, I got Peking duck, I got sweet and sour chicken, I got chop suey, and I got noodles. Take your pick.
No pizza.
No pizza.
Shit.
No shit either.
Watch these eyes burn you, Moose.
That you advocate peace, and yet you have armed security all over the place.
Peace? Please. He is keeping it. You don't seem to understand that guns don't kill unless someone pulls the trigger. We are here to change people's attitudes, not to deprive them of their constitutional rights. Now, ladies and gentlemen, if you'll excuse me, I'm very tired. I'm very hungry.
Now, Mr. Foxwood, come.
Sorry, ma'am. The professor is tired. Or maybe you didn't hear.
Mr. Foxwood!
That's it. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much.
And so it would seem that this unassuming and yet obviously powerful man, to whom the world continually pays tribute for his almost remorseless, dare one say, fanatical dedication to his international peace campaign, is to be rewarded once again. Professor Foxwood has accepted what some might see as a decidedly ambiguous honor, although no doubt with his individual brand of philosophy, he would refute it. He's to be made an honorary general in the Norwegian army, and will be here in Norway to receive his stripes and at the same time open a new building in his name. This is Lane Brewis for Australian Independent Network Television.
Yes. The 5 o'clock plane? I'm very pleased to hear it. Foxwood's probably a genius, but like most clever people, he is difficult sometimes. You must understand. Good. Look, if the president insists, the old man gets 24-hour protection, right? It's important. Of course it's important. And I quote, "No one single person has ever done so much to make the world aware of the true value of peace." Apparently, Russia is in total agreement. We'll be out of a job soon. Okay.
Mr. Cotland?
Yes?
For you.
Thank you. Hello, yes? I'll be there in half an hour. Sorry, Melinda. I've got to go.
Not again.
An important client. The law doesn't care about indigestion. Say hello to your father. And pass my congratulations. I'll fix your cab. Can you get a cab for the lady, please?
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Miss Foxwood, are you there?
Yes.
Can you get over to the American National Building? Ask for Atkinson in Mr. Goodman's office.
Yes. I'll come right over.
Should I cancel the flight, sir?
Yes, damn it.
I'm sorry, Harry. It's not your fault, is it? The stupid part of it is, although Foxwood organization has our backing, that's very unofficial. This has to be a police matter. We can't afford to be seen. It's got to be the Russians. Damn it. I knew this would happen.
How the hell did you get in here?
I'm Melinda Foxwood.
I know who you are. How in the hell did you get so far without being spotted by the security?
I'm my father's daughter.
He figures. Have a seat.
No, thanks. What are you going to do about it?
There is not much we can do.
Wonderful.
Except investigate. Look, Miss Foxwood. Under normal circumstances, you wouldn't even get close to me. I'm gonna try a long shot. Take a look at it. There are a bunch of vehicles calling themselves the Action Force Team. They claim to be dedicated to helping out anyone in trouble, like some kind of Robin Hoods. They send a kind of pamphlet out advertising themselves. We had them under investigation. Figured they might be dangerous. But they seem harmless enough. Just a bunch of idealistic amateurs. Miss Foxwood, you might consider them if you are desperate enough.
Of course I'm desperate enough.
All right.
But don't you say I didn't warn you? That's your man. Here is a number.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Mr. Honeycutt?
That's right, Miss Foxwood. Please, sit down. Can I get you something?
No, thanks. Can we get down to business?
Sure.
You don't mind me asking, but are you nuts?
Yeah, totally. In the nicest possible way.
Do you know who I am?
Yeah.
You know what happened to my father?
Yeah.
Can you help?
I wouldn't be here if I couldn't. Have you had a ransom demand?
Yeah. It's right here.
Close down all activities associated with your father's peace initiative or suffer the consequences. It's a pretty tall order. No money demanded?
Not a dime.
Then this is purely political.
Another Sherlock Holmes.
Go to work. Okay, guys, gather around. I got something to tell you. I just talked to the professor's daughter. She wants us to help find her old man.
Don't be ridiculous, George.
How are we gonna do that?
It's impossible.
Hey, Tom, nothing's possible. Days when we just used to read about adventure or go watch it at the movies are over. Now it's time to experience adventure in reality.
George, the optimist.
See, I have a theory about this Professor Foxwood. He just happens to be one of the world's foremost peace campaigners. Now, according to his daughter, almost his entire fortune is going to this peace thing. And my theory is that both the East and the West are going to try and put the brakes on it.
Have you figured all this out?
Well, it's obvious, isn't it? I mean, neither the KGB nor the CIA feel comfortable when there's too much peace around. They want to keep the balance of terror that exists right now as it is. So if all the professor's dough goes on a ransom... But don't you see, guys? Of course, you can't pay us too much, but it's the adventure and the excitement that really counts, right?
Don't we get any money?
Well, the girl can pay us a little bit of money out of her own pocket. We get $10,000 each.
Whee! 10 grand.
Holy smoke.
Okay, George. We're in.
I knew I could count on you guys. Let's get packed.
Have I missed anything?
How do you know he's in Europe?
I've made inquiries.
I think I know who's got him, and where.
You know? But...
It could be very dangerous for you. I suggest...
In the strongest possible terms, that you go about on your normal everyday business and leave the rest of us. Did you get in touch with our hat band of do-gooders?
Yes, I did. And I think this Honeycutt guy is on the level. I might just send him to Europe.
Now, see here. Here, Miss Foxwood. Jesus Christ. Stupid girl.
Okay, guys. Important. Study, learn, and remember. Now, you gotta learn the plans off by heart. Plans 1 through to 50, pretty simple. From then on, it gets a whole lot tougher.
I don't like that one.
Which one's that, Matt?
Plan 5-5.
Ah, Plan 5-5 only goes into action as a last resort. It's the point of no return, guys. Plan 5-5. Death before dishonor.
Vodka, Doc.
Where the hell is Eddie?
Eddie's on the can.
Can? Hey, this is important. You're gonna screw it up, Eddie.
Jason, what am I gonna do?
I think you should seriously consider doing what they ask. After all, it's your father's life.
Damn it, Jason. I'm not giving in to their demands. My father's worked too hard and too long. He'd throw up at the idea. And anyway, do you know what it would take to close down an organization the size of Dad's?
Your dad is about the most valuable member of the human race right now.
Tell me something I don't know.
If you want to avoid the whole parade that begins with the police and ends with the CIA.
Absolutely.
Then do it. At least let the people know. You take them seriously.
God damn it, Jason. Whose side are you on?
He's no good to anyone dead.
What?
Honey, I'm just being realistic.
Terrific. Great.
You asked for my advice. I'm giving it to you.
What if they kill him anyway?
There is a risk.
A risk? Christ, Jason!
You're behaving like a spoiled brat, Melinda. Has it occurred to you that you can't have the cake and eat it?
I can't believe I'm hearing this. Thanks a lot.
Guys, let's get to it.
Show him, Matt.
Matt, you're deader than a dinosaur's dick.
Oh!
Come on, Matt.
Shit for brains. Having a little fun.
Oh!
They don't look that tough to me. I bet you $5 I can beat him.
Okay, this I gotta see.
Mind over muscle never fails. You owe me $5, mister. Come on, Sonny, let's go. Come on.
Billy, get over here. I gotta talk to you.
What are they talking about? What's going on?
Weapons are no problem. He thinks he's got a hideout for us, too.
What?
I said he... never mind.
Mr. Honeycutt in?
Yes, should I call his room?
Don't bother.
Wait, where are you going?
Explain to him, Harry.
Who are you? What do you want?
Oh, shut up. Mr. Honeycutt? George Honeycutt?
Who wants to know?
Matt? Moose? Tom? Hello?
CIA, fellas. The all-knowing, all-seeing CIA.
You got your ad in the mail. Very enterprising. A little weird, though. And risky. We did a little legwork. If you want to know, I can tell you almost everything about yourselves. Billy, I know what you usually have for breakfast. Can't you get anything better? All right, gentlemen, let's put our cards on the table. We all know what the situation is. What I say now is strictly off the record. If you try to find me or contact me, or mention my involvement, you'll find I don't exist, and everything will be denied. From now on, you are on your own. Understand? We want Foxwood back. He's been held at Norheim Castle, one of two neutral safe houses. We use it, so do the Russians.
Hey, wait a minute.
No question. I'll do my best to make sure that you are not disturbed by bureaucracy. That's it.
That's it.
If you believe the protagonist in this affair is one of your countrymen, Fred Goodman, why don't you deal with him?
For the same reason you wouldn't interfere if he were one of yours, on your own territory. But this man is operating a cable in a neutral zone that threatens to destroy a good thing both our countries have to take care of. Now, I would have thought that pulling joint of resources would be beneficial, not only to us as individuals, but to general good of worldwide peace. Unofficially, of course.
How about it?
We should not be having this conversation. It's worth some thought.
I see. No problem. Everything is under control. Don't worry. Have I ever let you down before? We're gonna make it. I promise. Yes, of course. All right. What did you say?
Enjoy it.
Yeah. Hey, you said there was only one of them.
I never could count. Exactly the same thing on the other side of the building. You think you can manage that? Okay. Well, I guess that's it. Good luck, fellas.
I hope we're gonna make it.
Hey, come on, we're the Action Force team, right? Okay, let's go.
Gunner, I'm gonna mix his brains with the wallpaper.
Drop the gun, Joe.
Let it do what he says, Joe.
Joe. Drop it.
Oh!
were a man of peace.
Who are you?
I'll explain it all later. Professor, we don't have much time. I'm working for your daughter. Listen, sir, can we just get the hell out of here, please?
You dropped the gun!
Time.
Take it easy, Professor. I'll get you to a hospital.
Listen, damn it!
A tape. Information. Vital. That. Zellheim.
Find it. Please.
I don't understand.
Incompetent, useless bunch of words cannot describe what I would like to do with you. How could you let a couple of amateurs take away Foxwood from right under my nose? Well, I'm not giving up now, am I? Those idiots are wandering around in no man's land. Anyone with the right resources can go in there. The Russians, the Americans, us. What's your name?
Gray, sir.
Get the message out and offer the man that disposes of Foxwood and friends. 1 million. And Gray.
Sir?
Get it right this time.
Yes, sir.
There's a tape somewhere. It's in the vaults at Zellheim. We gotta find it. Something to do with national security. It's the last thing he said. Jesus Christ! I gotta call Melinda.
What if she ain't home?
It's a computerized relay number. Reaches her anywhere in the world.
Come on, George. Save it. They'll be kissing our asses soon.
Drive, Tom.
The girl, pretty.
Oh, I heard one say his name.
Yeah, I know where it is.
Okay, please. Yeah,
yes, sir. Okay, let's get out of here before the local sheriff arrives.
Oh,
Come in.
We've got it upstairs.
Good. Send Atkinson in.
Kill two birds with one stone. Line for Melinda. Replace her father. And these talent action, whatever they call themselves, will turn up to save her.
You want to see me?
Yes. Sit down. Did you find out any more about his people?
They just popped up. There's five of them.
Do they worry you?
I'm not sure I understand.
I've put a lot of time and money into this operation. You know as well as I do what our Russian employees will do if this screws up. It mustn't. Simple as that.
Of course not.
Do we agree?
100%.
100%?
Yes.
Are you sure?
What's wrong?
I had you figured of one of my most loyal and reliable men. I know about the letter. That's what really hurts. Get down here before Atkinson messes up the rug.
The building on the right side of the wing and all that sort of stuff.
Wrong here.
Indeed there is. And it's you.
Who the fuck's this?
That's my fiancé.
Your fiancé?
Jason, what's going on?
You really are an ignorant, silly little girl, aren't you?
You're behind all this.
Got an in one.
You killed my father.
That was a nuisance. Held things up a bit.
I loved you. I loved you. You miserable son of a bitch! Why?
That would take too long to explain. In short, ideals influenced by money.
Thank you.
to your company.
Oh, no.
Are you all right?
Stop Zellheim military installation.
Answer A, here. 23 kilometers to left. We go here.
Attention.
Hi. Colonel Gonzalez, I have here written authority to see the tape vaults. Let's not do it, Sergeant. We don't care all day.
May I see your pass, please, sir?
Naturally. Of course you can see my pass, Sergeant. You can see all of my passes.
This is the most important one. Now you do exactly what I say, or I'm gonna blow your balls away. Poetry.
Sergeant.
Hey, Davies, take over here for a moment, will you?
Hi, guys.
I'm taking over here now, men. So listen closely. It's a cow here, and it's going up the airfield here. At the same time, this aircraft is ready for takeoff here. And this aircraft is moving at 740 kilometers. What happens to the cow when she's standing here shitting? You.
I don't know, sir.
You don't know? I'll tell you. She's still shitting, right?
Get back in there, Sergeant. Nice and slow. Take your time.
Nice to meet you.
Nothing.
it works better if you plug it in.
I'll take it. Throw it down. Throw it down. Threw it down.
Miss Foxwood?
Mr. Honeycutt!
Do you know what's on that tape?
No.
I hope you're speaking the truth. See, nobody knows exactly except a privileged few. Among these few are the president, of course me, and your father, since he formulated the info it contains. Professor Foxwood's theory was that instead of turning the other cheek in order to keep peace, you have to know what the enemy has and make sure you've got better. Will you come down and take the tape, please? What the whole world does, except your father made it believe that he was its greatest villain. People in high places all over the world parted from information and fun they normally never would have. And the professor recorded everything in detail.
You mean my father was a spy?
Oh, no. A patriot. The like of which you'll probably never see again. This decodes the tape with solar energy. It's extremely sensitive. However, if the tape is bounced around, an ordinary bedside lamp will get it going. It's the only flaw in an otherwise perfect invention. Again, it's your father's creation. I hope for your sakes, the tape will not play.
He forgot to plug it in.
I understand. Everything seems to be all right. It's useless. You have been lucky this time. Come on, let's go.
$10,000.
Excuse me for a moment.
$10,000.
Thought you might like a change from hospital food.
Chinese?
No. Pizza. Pizza.